From Northern Avenue in Yerevan, this is Civil Nets Daily News Digest. I'm Maria Titizian, and here are the top stories for Tuesday, February 25. The Prime Ministers of Armenia and Russia meet in Sochi. Also, see what took place in the National Assembly yesterday between a parliamentarian and a minister. Plus, former President Robert Kocharyan says Armenia should never have begun negotiations to join the European Union's association agreement. And later, security analyst Sambel Mardirosyan talks about hacking wars in the region on hidden people. The high cost of customs duties on certain products was one of the issues discussed yesterday during a meeting in Sochi between Prime Minister of Armenia Dikran Sarkisyan and Russian Prime Minister Dmitry Medvedev. Sarkisyan was there to participate in the closing ceremonies of the 2014 Winter Olympics. During the meeting, the Prime Ministers discussed the preparations for Armenia's membership into the customs union, economic cooperation, Armenia's Medzamor nuclear power plant, labor migration, and the upcoming donors conference. Following their meeting, Prime Minister Medvedev said, quote, "Today we had the possibility to discuss all aspects of Armenian-Russian cooperation, the level of preparations that have been realized for Armenia's membership into the customs union, and how to implement the roadmap." The Armenian Prime Minister, for his part, said that there is over 1,000 Russian companies operating in Armenia. He noted, "Russia occupies the first place in terms of investment volumes in the country. We hope that in the future these investments will continue in different spheres in Armenia." Yesterday, the Armenian parliament paid tribute to those who were killed in the Ukrainian uprising. Levon Zurabyan, a member of parliament for the opposition Armenian National Congress, tabled a proposal that all members honor, quote, "those who were killed in Kiev as a result of deadly weapons used by the authorities," end of quote, with a moment of silence before the four-day session began. Hovik Abrahamyan, the Speaker of the Parliament and a member of the ruling Republican Party of Armenia, suggested that they also pay tribute to Ukrainian security forces who were killed in the protests. When high-ranking state officials use crude or what may be considered vulgar language in their statements, it inevitably leads to much discussion, and not only on the pages of social media, but also in Parliament. Justice Minister Hrant Tovmasyan seems to have gotten himself into some hot water when he commented on the opposition's intention to table a motion in Parliament for non-confidence in the government. He said, "They're making a mistake." However, in a style of language that can be considered rude and objectionable. Yesterday in Parliament, ARF faction leader Armer Rustamyan responded by saying that the Justice Minister should not be offended henceforth if opposition MPs make similar comments, and proceeded to offer an example in a similarly crude manner. This led to an uproar in Parliament, and members were asked several times to settle down. Parliamentary Speaker Hovik Abrahamyan said that he regretted the use of such expressions in Parliament. What happens when several state agencies make contradictory statements when trying to clarify or interpret a law? The answer is confusion, and that is exactly what is taking place in Armenia over the controversial new pension law that went into effect on January 1 of this year. After much public pressure, the issue landed in the Constitutional Court, which in turn suspended two provisions of the law until it handed down a final decision expected on March 28. In the meantime, it was not clear whether employers would have to make the necessary deductions from workers' wages until the decision. Several groups, including over 300 employees of the Medzamor nuclear power plant, had applied to the human rights defender Garen Andreasyan to shed light on the situation. In his turn, Andreasyan yesterday applied to the Constitutional Court, explaining in detail the ruling confusion in the country and asking for clarification. Meanwhile, pension protesters in the country led by the Dem.am movement are planning their next steps. The organizers have said that they are willing to cooperate with those political forces in the country that stand in unity with the demonstrators and who don't try to pursue their own political policies or expect to glean political dividends. Dem.am is planning to hold a large protest on March 22nd ahead of the expected decision of the Constitutional Court on March 28. Armenia's membership into the Russian-led customs union could lead to an increase in the cost of living, harm local industry, and lead to trade sanctions by other countries. This is what former President Robert Kocharyan said yesterday in what has been a series of public statements in recent months. He said that higher customs duties enforced by the union would not only potentially increase prices for many of the products imported into the country, but might create problems with the World Trade Organization and also lead the European Union to scrap its preferential trade regime with Armenia. Kocharyan added that President Sarkisian should never have embarked on negotiations with the European Union to sign the association agreement, and that their current scramble to join the customs union without properly assessing the needs and interests of the country will be detrimental. In a report issued yesterday, the Central Bank of Armenia said that the country's GDP will grow by 5.4 to 6.1% by the end of the year due to growth in industry and services. According to the bank's short-term projections, consumer consumption will increase by 5.3%, while private investments will rise by 3.9%. Real increase in exports of goods and services will hover between 11 to 13%. Imports and private transfers are expected to increase by 3.5% and 7.9% respectively. The central bank expects Armenia's economic growth to stabilize at about 5 to 6%. The 2014 state budget forecasts economic growth at 5.2%. Being a security analyst also means you track and report on hacking trends in the region. For Hidden People, I got the chance to sit down with lecturer, journalist, and information technology expert Samvel Mardirosyan and talk about cyber wars in the Caucasus and social media trends and their impact in the region. Here's a short clip. To watch the full episode of Hidden People, you can follow the link on your screen. Yesterday, the official opening ceremonies of the first ever Pan-Armenian Winter Games opened in Zakhgatsor. Armenian athletes from Armenia, Artsakh, and around the world will compete in skiing, alpine skiing, snowboarding, and ice hockey. CivilNet's crew was at the ceremonies and spoke with organizers and athletes, including Olympic alpine skier Arman Serebrakian, who has just returned from Sochi. We will be bringing you more coverage of the games in the coming days. The exchange rate is up on your screen as we take a look at your forecast. It's going to be a sunny day in Yerevan with a high of 10 degrees Celsius and a low of minus 1. Armenia's second largest city, Gyumri, will have a high of 2 and a low of minus 9. Stepanakert, the capital of Artsakh, will have a high of 10 with a low of 2. And our travel forecast takes us to the beautiful city of Buenos Aires, Argentina, where the high will be 17 and the low 7. Armenians have been migrating to Argentina since the early years of the 20th century. The first major wave of Armenian migration began in the 1920s as a consequence of the Armenian Genocide. Many of the Armenian migrants to Argentina